we're going to say which substance, for example, two, which substance has greater molar entropy? So this will be, we're going to compare these two, and these two. So within those three choices, we're going to choose the best out of each one. So the first one we have CH4 gas or CCl4 liquid. Now, the way you look at these types of questions is you first look at their phases. Okay, so we first look at phases. And all you're going to say here is gases have higher entropy than liquids. And liquids have higher entropy than solids. Now, if they're tied in the same phase, then we move on to complexity. And what the heck do I mean by complexity? All I'm saying is the more elements that make up the compound, the more entropy. So the more elements that make up the compound, then the more entropy. So for example, if I gave you CO2 gas versus S8 gas, you would say that CO2 is made up of three different atoms, one carbon, two oxygens. And S8 is made up of eight atoms of sulfur. So it has more elements that make it up, so it has more entropy. So S8 would have more entropy. Now, if they have the same number of elements that make them up, then we go to overall mass. And here for three, you're going to say more mass equals more entropy. Because think of it like this. We said that entropy is chaos, destruction, disorder, randomness. So if we want to think about it, think of it as two cars on a highway. You have a little Mini Cooper versus a Hummer. Okay, you're going to say that the Hummer is much larger, and if it gets in an accident, it's going to cause more destruction, more disorder. So we're going to say the Hummer has a greater mass compared to the smaller car, compared to the Mini Cooper. So just think of it in those terms. More mass equals bigger size equals more chaos that we can have. So here, there are different phases, so we can easily say it's the gas. Now, for the next one, they're both gases. So the first one doesn't help us. Let's look at the second criteria. We're going to say complexity. Here, both have the same number of atoms. One. There's only one neon, one xenon. So that doesn't help us. So then we move on to the third one, mass. We're going to say that xenon on our periodic table has a higher atomic mass than neon. And because of that, xenon has a higher entropy. Then finally, let's look at the last one. We have CH3OH liquid versus C6H5OH liquid. So they both have the same phase again, so the first rule doesn't help us. What we do next is we look at complexity. We're going to say C6H5OH definitely has more elements that make it up, so it's more complex, more moving parts, more chances of chaos and entropy. So we're going to say C6H5 has more entropy. Now, you could have also simply said that C6H5 has a greater mass, and because of that, it should have the greater entropy. So remember, delta S is just chaos or disorder. The farther molecules are from each other in their phases, then the greater the entropy. So gaseous compounds have more entropy than liquids or solids. And we're going to say that the natural tendency of the universe is to be in disorder. So the second law of thermodynamics is saying that the universe is going to shit. Or you can just say that the second law of thermodynamics is saying that the entropy of the universe must always be greater than zero. Because if entropy is always increasing in our universe, there's no chance for it to be less than zero. Always has to be greater than zero. Just remember that for the second law of thermodynamics.